Okay. Anyhow, the halacha of today is we're talking about coming into the graves. So it says if you go close to the graves, 4 amas of the death or the grave, it's considered like going into what? Into Beis HaKvaros. And going into Beis HaKvaros is a problem of Loeg LaRash. You know, making a joke out of the deaf people. I can do what you cannot do. But, and that's why the place that they actually, sometimes they bury the dead person with the talus, what they do is they cut the strings, put the garment, and they cut the strings. So, also those people that carry the dead person, and they want to wear, you know, the talus also, so even though the Chaya would say it's for the dead person, still we say that the Shingon now with the talus. Now, the reason is that we don't go to the graves, and you know, even though you're far away from the grave itself, it's just a graveyard, but you're far away from the grave itself. So he says, even in the grave of a kid, why? Because sometimes there's a gilgul of a big neshama. We don't know, but maybe if it has a gilgul of a big neshama, that's why we're afraid. The question of what happened with the woman. A woman all her life she never wear tzitzit. Besides the reformed people that, you know, they go to kosher. And when they feel, I don't know if the tzitzit is kosher. So I don't know if that's considered as something that you can be considered of. But for sure, you know, because for sure, Saddam is no question of Loeg LaRash. So where's the big machloikis if you're allowed to wear talis or not? If it's only a woman's grave, and then Kondim Shnumer Rashma, it's okay. But it brings away other views that really will also choshesh for that. It's nice with the name of the Marit, it's long, that we should be lechumer. Anyhow, so what happens now, this is a big question, so people want to do, you know, minyonim, you know. So it says it's better to keep 4 amas away from the grave, when you have minyonim to do, you know, like a pray, shacharis, or whatever it is. Now, Kaddish himself, when you go next to the grave, that since it's for the death himself, so there is no problem. But other minyonim and stam minyonim, since it's really not, it's not really connected, so some people say it's better to keep 4 amas from the grave himself, in order to do the davening. Now, another one thing, what happened when a dead person is in a room? He's sitting in a room, so over there, and we consider the whole room, from Galadam, so the whole room you can daven or not. So over here, the Chazanish says we don't see that issue. But for sure, to eat in this place, eating, that's already another issue. So it comes out of eating, it's like a disgrace for the dead person. Imagine a person sit down in the grave and he eats there and all those things. That's for sure, it's not an appropriate thing. So that's for sure we say that you shouldn't do that. Eating in the graveyard, next to the graveyard, or in the Beis HaKvaros, what they do is general today in Israel, that like it's pleasure when the people get together. Over there, it's like a gathering together. So over there, it's like before the grave, it's like a separate thing. That thing, we say that it could be that you that people eat. It's like made, it's not really part of Beis HaKvaros, it's like a separate entity. So then you're like, you know, people can drink and eating after that. So that you could do that. Anyhow, have a good day today. Amen.